before I wanted to be a paramedic, I was trying to write. I wanted to be a writer. I wanted to be, for maybe even probably like 5 years after I graduated, I just moved. I was moving around the country. I was working like as dishwasher or just selling T-shirts on the street or any sort of job I could pick up. And I was writing. I was writing stories. A lot of stories like with no plots, like little epiphanies or something, and they were terrible. I was just trying to learn how to write. So this goes on for about 5 years, and one day I was working in New Orleans, and I saw I was coming home. I was working in a bookstore, and I saw someone. I heard what I thought were firecrackers. I looked up, and it was a guy walking toward me with a gun. There was someone lying in the street. They were shot, and I thought the guy was going to shoot me. He was holding, like, he was literally like had the gun out, walking toward me. And I just we were on just the two of us in the street. We stopped. He got in the car. He drove away, and I ran down. I watched this woman die. I was freaked out. Like, I thought I should have known what to do, and so I become an EMT, and then I moved to New York. I work on an ambulance. I become a paramedic. I get a job for the New York City Fire Department. So as soon as I started working, I had already been writing or trying to write for about 5 years, or at least 5 or 6 years, but I didn't have anything to write about. I didn't know what I was supposed to write. And then as soon as I started working on the ambulance, every single day I had more stories than I saw more in 1 week than I'd ever seen in my life. And so it was just natural that I would start to write about the things I saw. And so that's how I ended up, that's how I ended up writing it. But once I started writing it, also there were so many pressures on the job. It was a way to process it, it was psychologically helpful to write down the things you saw. It was a way of dealing with it. I did not go as far to the dark side as this character. I lived in that world and I understood how it can happen, but it's fiction. But having said that, the world that's depicted and the jobs on the ambulance that are in the book are totally true or could have happened. There's nothing there that isn't possible. It's not like total fiction, as in it's presenting the real world as I saw it. The world that was being depicted is a dark, hard world, and that's the social aspects. It's true. I mean, there's a whole section of New York, or particularly at that time, that was totally neglected, like complete. They just, at that time, in the 90s, at some point, half the buildings in Harlem were owned by the city because the owners just walked away. The buildings weren't even worth the taxes they were paying on them. So the city just took over. Harlem lost a third of its population during that time. Buildings just abandoned, block after block of abandoned buildings, and just basically complete social collapse. And people who were literally half a mile away or a mile away, they had no idea what was going on uptown. Like, people, no one went up there, and so I wanted to write about it. But there was also, it is hope. I mean, I don't want to, like, I think there was, there is hope, and Harlem is strange in that there is a real resilience in Harlem where people have a real sense of community there. I ended up living there for it. So I worked there for 5 years, but my last like 2.5 years, I lived up in Harlem. I liked it. It's the center of African American culture, and also like other, it's not mono-ethnic. It's a lively place. So I wanted to show some hope. And also, even beyond that, just on the human level, it does end with hope.